In this video, we'll dive into the elements you can use to create automated flows with our Automation 360. First, go to the Automations tab and click Create New Automation. Fill in the campaign information, the sender's email address and name, priority days for sending, and unsubscribe form language. Then choose the starting condition of the flow. For example, when a new subscriber is added to a mailing list, on a special date, or when a variable value changes. With SendPulse, you can also set up a custom event that will trigger your automated flow, like a registration, purchase, or abandoned cart. You'll find a detailed guide to setting up these events in the description below. You can use the email element to send an email automatically. To do so, select the element execution time, indicate the email subject line, and choose a previously created email template. You can combine emails with web push notifications, SMS, and messengers to create a multi-channel communication strategy with your customers. The filter element allows you to send flow messages based on specific variables in your mailing list. For instance, after an email, you can add an SMS that will be sent in 2 days to only subscribers whose city variable value is Chicago. Using the condition element, you can set up sending subsequent messages only if a specific condition is met or not. Conditions include the following types of events: message delivered, email opened, or subscriber clicked through the links in the previous message. The action element can be used to move, copy, and delete a subscriber or update their variable value. Using this element, you can also randomly split your contacts for A/B testing. The send to my email address option allows you to get notifications about the user's action in your autoflow. Another element you can use for your autoflows is goal. Add it to the required flow element to track the number of subscribers who reach this goal. You can automatically stop the flow as soon as the goal is reached. Drag the messenger element into your flow. Connect it to the element, after which you need to send a message from your chatbot or launch a chatbot flow. Select the element's runtime, immediately, after a specific amount of time, or at a specific date and time. Select the bot you want to run. You can also add multiple messenger elements and launch multiple chatbots at once if your subscribers are subscribed to your bots on multiple social networks. Choose an action. Send a message or launch a flow. In the text section, enter the text of the message that will be sent to the selected chatbots. You can add variables and emoji to your text. Drag the push element into the editor field and select the recipients of your push message. Specify the sending time of the first notification. Enter the title and text of your notification. Also, you can add other variables here. Add the link that the recipient will follow after clicking on your notification. Optionally, you can replace the default image. Set the push lifecycle, the period where the message can be delivered to the subscriber. By default, the push lifecycle is set to 24 hours. You can add a Viber element to send service messages, for example, about order confirmation and status, delivery of goods, or debiting or crediting bonuses. Drag the Viber element to the flow. Connect it to the element after which you need to send the message. Click Save and exit.